Today our lecture on the basis of your static field, that is your electrostatic and magnetostatic field. After static field, we go to the your time varying field. This one your relationship between E and V, electric field and voltage. You see here the line integral of electric field, a closed path must be zero. This implies that net work is done in a moving charge along a closed path in a electrostatic field is equal to zero. Suppose this one path is in a electric field. This your closed path is present in a electric field. This one shows your relation. Means E dot dl, line integral of electric field equal to zero. This one shows you. Means complete integrated path. If complete this one loop is present in the electric field. This value is equal to zero. Means line integral of electric field in a closed path must be zero. These are the relation in a static field. If we apply the Stokes theorem used in a line to surface conversion, this one shows you line to surface conversion, del cross is ds. Now this surface integral to move to this side, then equal to zero. Now this is come to, this is your differential form, this is your integral form of relation. Now this means electric field is irrotational. Also, this also implies that the electric field is a conservative nature of, means electrostatic field is a conservative nature of field. Here the heading is E and V relation, but here don't see any relation between E and V. You see here we write only V is equal to E dot dl, line integral of electric field, E dot dl. You noted in your mind. This is one, V is equal to E dot dl, E and V relation. Also in a del operator, relation between E and V, E electric field is equal to minus del operator and V. This one also relation of E and V. You here noted only point, this one means electric field is irrotational in a static field. What is means rotational? Rotational such like your magnetic field is rotational. If path follow here, this one magnetic field. In electric field irrotational means, suppose there is a point charge Q and someone here there is a negative charge Q. Then electric field is linear from point charges to terminate to negative charges. Only one direction. Originate from positive charges and terminate to negative charge. That is a irrotational. Next to move to Bio-Savart's law. In Bio-Savart's law, you see here, this is your a wire, current carrying wire, flow of current is I. Suppose this one is a inner length L and we take a differential length, means in a small length, in this length we have taken a small section, that is named given to differential length, and this differential length to a particular distance R, there is point P. Now this particular point P, we calculate the magnetic field, and between this current element and the point P, there is angle between alpha. Now the Bio-Savart law says that differential magnetic field is proportional to current element and also proportional to angle between current element and measuring point of magnetic field point P, and inversely proportional to 1 upon r square. This one shows you by Savart's law. Also, is proportionality removed, we use k, k constant, k is value is 1.45. If we put the value, this one come to relation. Okay, we move to next Ampere circuit law. In Ampere circuit law, this states that the line integral of magnetic field H around a closed path is exactly same as the current enclosed by the path. This means if a current carrying wire, suppose this is a wire, flow a current I, then around this current element there is flow of current, this around the current there is a magnetic field. This one shows your current element and this one shows your magnetic field. Around the current wire there is a magnetic field. The direction is found using the right hand rule. This one come your direction of magnetic field if you use your right hand rule. This one is relation Ampere circuit law. S dot BL is equal to I enclosed. The I equal to J dot ZS. J is the current density. Also you see the relation when we not use a integral form or vector form. J is equal to I upon a current per unit area. Now I is equal to, this implies that I is equal to J cross A. You arrange this J is equal to I upon A, then come to J cross A. This one shows only this is your J. The integral of ds is called A. Also this is a vector form, this is a only point form. Now use the Stokes theorem, convert the line to surface. Line to surface, this one convert to line to surface, and both side now surface integral, then cancel out. This one come your differential form of relation Ampere circuit law. Okay, next to magnetic flux density. Magnetic flux density also related such like your electric flux density. In electric flux density you see in the previous lecture D is equal to permeability multiply by electric field. You also see here the unit is coulomb per meter square. In electric flux density here you see the magnetic flux density is the product of permeability and magnetic field density H. The unit is magnetic flux density is the Weber per meter square. Actually the Weber is the unit of the magnetic flux and the magnetic flux density unit is the Weber per meter square. Also some relation is the use in, if we use mu r equal to 1 free space and consider, then we put the mu is equal to mu r. You see here the magnetic flux through a surface relation is represented here. The psi is equal to b dot ds means surface integration of magnetic flux density. This one is equal to 0. This shows you means suppose there is a magnet that is one of the north pole and second is the south pole, and magnetic flux winds from north to south, this one, and flow inside this means closed path is follow north to south flow magnetic flux. Now anywhere you take it as area, surface area, and passes the magnetic flux, this one your magnetic flux passes the magnetic flux in this surface area, consider a circular loop type, then this passes the, this only shows you relation means the magnetic flux passes through this surface area equal to 0. This one shows you also a Maxwell equation. This is convert using a surface to volume divergence theorem and convert in a differential form. This one shows you, this one shows you any surface area, consider this is a surface area and magnetic field passes through this one. Now this surface area and passes the magnetic flux is equal to 0. This one shows you relation. This means the isolated magnetic charge does not exist. Isolated means here you see north and south pole as considered two charges. Now if we break this one, then again come to the north and south pole in each parts of your magnet. This one shows you relation. also this one are Maxwell equation. Now to move summarize form in a static field, this is a Gauss law derived, and this is a conservation of electrostatic field, and this is another Ampere circuit law, and the last one is isolated magnetic field. This is a summarized form of all the laws in a static field. If in terms of integral form, this one your shows you relation. Next, move to time varying field. In the time varying field,